Amit Aggarwal mere favorite designers mein se ek hai, especially because wo sustainable fashion banate hain. His garments always are made with recycled industrial material. Is baar unhone wasted traditional sarees jo jiski koi value nahi hoti, log usse istemal nahi karte, discarded purani saariyon ke borders, un sab cheezon ka istemal kiya hai to create a really spectacular line. And I'm really happy ki designers mein ye consciousness aa gaya hai ki wo sustainable fashion ki taraf jaye aur aise kapde banaye jo sab pehen sakte hain aur pehnte waqt ye bhi soch sakte hain ki kuch acha ho raha hai vatavaran.
Yeah, क्या highlights मिली हैं जो आपको उसके बारे में जानना चाहिए?
I think the most amazing thing about Amit Aggarwal and this show today is the fact that he's shown us how to use discarded saris and discarded industrial material very, very interestingly and beautifully.
Okay, तो इस बार आप भी walk करने वाले हैं ramp पे कल परसों में, या उसके बारे में जानना चाहेंगे?
I'm looking forward to being the showstopper for Kusum and Karishma, Fabiana. That's going to be on the 20th, I think. Yeah, on the 20th. It's a really stunning outfit. True blue Amit Aggarwal style. This garment has a combination of industrial waste, discarded old borders and pieces of fabric. And I love it.
Should we stand? Can we stand? Is it okay for the cameras? Yeah? Okay, no one said yes or no.
Could I request media to please squeeze in so we can close the door and begin the interactions? Good evening, everyone. A fantastic presentation that we just got to witness. The Monaco Tourism presents Amit Aggarwal's show. Amit, a fantastic presentation all in all. Complete, it was a beautiful showcase of construction, style, detailing, and embellishments. As always, your shows never disappoint. I'd like to take the opportunity, because this has been in association with Monaco Tourism. So I'd love to hear from Mr. Rajiv Nangia, India Director, Monaco Government Tourist Bureau, about collaborating with a designer like Amit. What was his vision and why did you decide to take such a brilliant designer on when it came to this season of LFW?
First of all, I'd like to congratulate him for making show extra, extra, extra grandeur. And also thank you to lady here who did a brilliant job on the ramp. I mean, it was amazing. I've seen so many shows. I've been coming here for the last 3 years now. But it was, I think, fabulous. And the reason why we collaborated with Amit was very simple. It was about sustenance. It was about heritage. It was about culture. And it was about art. When we talk about luxury, especially in Monaco, we talk about responsibility also alongside, and sustenance is a very big part of it. And that's one of the reasons we found that this is the gentleman who is doing justice to luxury. And that's what all collaboration came in together. And his inspiration from the some of the parts of Monaco were really outstanding and amazing today.
Amit, we'd love to hear from you about what it was like creating this amazing, amazing collection.
So honestly, for me, it was important that I transport the audience to a land. It could be a land very close to their heart, which was Banaras, or it could be a land far away, which was Monaco. I started working on the collection with upcycled Banarsi textiles. And in between, I got the chance to actually interact with Mr. Rajiv, and he said, why don't you visit Monaco, and why don't you have a... Yeah, so I had the chance to actually see the architecture of Monaco, understand how beautifully the buildings are casted, made. The palace there is gilded with gold, the tapestry, or even the upholstery and the window panels. All of that actually just added to the details of the Banarsi, because there is a very strong synonymous, I would say, aesthetic that goes between the textiles of Banaras, the opulence, and the motifs alongside the motifs at Monaco. And I thought it was a great opportunity to bring both of them together and create a completely new language. Here, I also thought it was important that we talk about sustainability or conscious fashion, because yes, I do understand that you know, a marriage or a bride-to-be sometimes you know, can get a little crazy with what she wants to have. But I think it's important to make a conscious decision. Right now, what this vision of mine is wearing is a beautifully molded corset, which is completely made from recycled plastic strips. And the bottom of it, which has taken around 600 hours of hand labor, is carefully detailed, if you see, with upcycled details from Banarsi borders or even little details of the plastic strips. So, yeah, opulent and yet conscious. Yes.
Perfect for the festive season, yes. Right in time. Esha, I just want to hear your thoughts about working with Amit when it came to, you know, taking on the showstopper look. How was it like? And when he told you this is what you'd be wearing, what was your initial reaction?
I think firstly, it was high time that I had to work for Amit. The amount of outfits of Amit's I've worn, like the ties, my stylist, come my best friend, like we actually fight. We are like, no, let's just wear Amit. And there have been times where I've just worn an Amit Aggarwal, and then there's another piece that'll come, and then we were like, should we wear it? We just wore it last week, and we actually end up wearing it. So I was like, I think, thank you, Amit, firstly. Like, it was high time. But coming to this outfit, it's beautiful. It's easy to walk in. And like Amit said, it's for the new age bride. And if you see now, brides are actually going, you know, a little different route, especially the destination weddings. And since Banaras is as India as it can get, and Morocco, I think, is a beautiful destination. I think something like this is perfect for a destination wedding.
The music also during the show, Amit, was just beautiful. I mean, it actually transported you to, you know, Banaras, yes. with the temple bells. What was the thought when you were conceptualizing, you know, the hair and makeup and the music for the show?
Well, I actually had the vision of, you know, the woman coming out of the Ganges. So how the hair was, or the filtering sun ray light, so all the strings that you saw, and it had to be the morning music. So the first temple aarti was the inspiration, but of course, if somebody actually carefully dissects the music, there was a lot of undertone of the church bells from the Western influences, where, you know, there is a marriage of both. The bell rings in both the places, and it creates the same kind of feeling.
Beautiful, really beautiful. So I'd love to hear from you, Mr. Rajiv. Any last thoughts about the association?
No, we'd like to thank Amit and Esha again. And of course, we have been lucky with the Indian clients actually taking Monaco as their destination wedding. In fact, we had a very big wedding last November from India with almost 800 people going to Monaco. And we hope, after getting inspired by the collection of Amit, we'll see more such weddings and celebrations coming to Monaco.
Thank you so much
once again.
I'd like to open the floor to media if you have any questions.
Amit, can you take us through the outfit? I know you did that, but a little more detail into the embroidery. Can you guys still see me? So I'll be here.
So the process of the outfit actually starts. I mean, if you see visually, it is a traditional lehenga, but how it has been deconstructed is important. The blouse has actually become like a molded corset now. And the bottom, the entire pattern of it is actually the morning sunrise in Banaras versus the glass, the stained glass panels of Monaco's beautiful palace there. So I think that was the marriage that I thought the last outfit should have. So it took around 10 karigars for that many days to finish it.
Amit, your designs are futuristic also? Some of the people say like your designs are futuristic also.
I actually completely shy away from that term because I think that when a lot of people don't understand what it looks like, they just term it futuristic. So yes, and I'm. It's taken me 8 years and enough guts to tell people that it's not futuristic because if you're seeing it right now, it's not the future.
It's just modern.
Yeah, it's more modern. It's something that blends culture and I think a modern approach. Yeah. That's about it. And it's not futuristic at all. It's not that a robot is going to be wearing my outfits.
Esha, you couldn't stop. We have to ask you. Are you open to experimenting, taking, breaking the barriers as far as your what you wear is concerned?
I think I've already done that. What I've not worn, I've already broken the barriers.
Can you? We are all here for this. What inspired you for the what you mentioned, like the photo shoot?
The same. I don't understand why people ask what inspired me because. I mean, I'm halfway through, so it's. I mean, there's nothing. I mean, there's whatever inspires you to look pretty and take a selfie. Same way I did the photo shoot, I was looking beautiful, and I was just like, let's just get a team together and we shot it.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, media. Just a request to our Mr. Raji.
We have two very special guests from Monaco with us. We have Charlotte and we have Isabel. I'll just request them to come here and say a thank you to our audience for giving us such a wonderful time today.
Hello, thank you very much for this show. It was stunning and all the dresses were amazing. Thank you very much. Thank you.